That was the impetus behind the establishment of Pearson College in his memory. We bring together, as you know, students from around the world, 160 students from approximately 80 countries, and they live, study, and work together. One World is a truly school-wide collaboration. The students do virtually everything. They write the scripts, they do the choreography, they audition one another, they run the rehearsals, they make the costumes, they do the sound and the light. It's a wonderful opportunity for them to sample each other's cult music, song, and dance, which is a very important element of understanding other cultures. So I would like to thank so many of you in the audience who've supported the school very generously with your donations. That's what made it possible for the school to be established 40 years ago. This is our 40th anniversary. And yes, thank you. And we hope very much that you will continue to help us bring these students of such promise and potential here to live together and to learn together on Vancouver Island. Thank you very much and enjoy the rest of the show.
Oh, Yeah. I am Silvia from Guatemala. I wrote this piece to other women who have sacrificed their human dignity in order to survive. Anna comes from three real stories. A girl whose father rejected her before she was born. A teenager who was sexually abused as a kid. And a woman who survived slavery before passing away. This is inspired in Latin America, but it's true all over the world. Writing this reminded me not to judge people, but instead to respect and understand that sometimes the silence cannot be broken. Recuerdo que le tenía pánico a los hombres.
¡Eh, bonita!
Recordaba cuando a los 8 años su primo le enseñó a andar en bicicleta. She was a woman. She grew up without a father. And she blamed herself for not being a boy. Because if she was, maybe her father would have seen her as being useful. I remember her panic towards strangers.
Hey, beautiful!
She hated those strangers. They reminded her of the time when she was 8. And she learned to ride a bike. Everyone loves bikes. She hates them.
Her cousin told her that if she let him touch her little thing and keep it between them, he would teach her to ride a bike. She let him touch her little thing because she wanted to learn. She simply kept for herself this childhood secret, the secret of her pain and anguish. As an adult, she didn't like anyone touching her, but she heard the little voice reminding her to keep quiet, because anyway, she was going to learn to ride a bike.
Later, she needed money to survive, to help her siblings and feed them. A man got a job for her, in which she did not need to be a brilliant student. It was enough to be a woman. She spent a great part of her life on that job, feeling that every man was that cousin that was going to teach her how to ride a bike. Everyone criticized her by telling her to learn to value herself, but no one ever offered any help. No one ever cared about her being silent. It wasn't convenient for anyone having her speak about her problems.
Who would have listened? Before working at the oldest and dirtiest profession, she had tried selling fruit, working as a nanny, but in the end, selling her body was the most feasible. She could even afford to buy a little whim now and then, like a sweater for winter. Still, the price was remaining silent her entire life, enduring the humiliation of her body at the hands of random men. Anna died in a hovel, believing she deserved what she lived.
Anna the servant, Anna the useless one, Anna the fool, Anna the pretty. When I asked Anna, how did it feel to die alone and homeless, she answered, I have more than 10 years of living like the dead, and I cannot tell you how. It is a secret. But at least I can ride bikes. I am not that useless because at least I accomplished one dream. Ana suspiró y cayó. Cayó para siempre. Dejó de respirar. Ana sighed and then was silent forever. She stopped breathing. And me?
I got tired of keeping Anna's secret with me.
I have to diminish more, and so that shall Anna in me.
Aku lelah menjaga rahasia Anna denganku.
Me cansé de guardar el secreto de Anna.
Thank you. Thank you, Sibia, Anna, Yam, Andrea, and Ruby. Shortly, we will have another indigenous dance called Inti Raymi. This means the celebration of the sun in Quechua, which is our Ecuadorian student Sisa's first language.
This will be followed by a contemporary dance called Adat Inti Melayu, which combines traditions and modernity. This dance was put together by a Malaysian student Alif and Ruli from Indonesia.
You may be wondering why you're seeing so much of us, your MCs. Of course, we want to give you as much information as we can about the acts you'll be seeing, but we're also helping out some of our fellow classmates with their costume changes. For example, Yam from Israel was in the last spoken word act and will be in the very next dance, the Vietnamese Hat Dance. This was led by our two Vietnamese students, Ha and Ai. The dance is meant to portray the beauty and grace of Vietnamese women. Is she done? Do you know any knock-knock jokes? I think she's done. Okay, without further ado, the Hat Dance.
Thank you.
una canismo como una estafa. Dador de vida, amor y sabiduría. Estamos reunidos aquí tus hijos, de todas partes del mundo como los colores de la huipala, para agradecerte por los rayos de vida que alimentan la vida en la Pachamama.
I'm not going to do that. all non-believers. You do not worship what I worship. Nor do I worship what you worship. Nor will you be worshippers of what I worship. Nor will I be a worshipper of what you worship. For you is your religion, and for me is my religion.
My name is Sawsan. I am a Palestinian Arab Muslim. I was taught that being an Arab Muslim is a privilege. This changed when I became aware of the world around me. Do not believe the stereotypes. We are not a warlike, uncouth, backward culture. You might have heard that culture in my region is only due to religion. It is not. I am a Palestinian Muslim woman. I am proud to say that my personality has been shaped by my Palestinian culture and my belief in Islam.
My name is Inaya, and I'm a Muslim. Just like you go to a doctor or counselor to get help when you need, my belief has been my perseverance to survive when the possible seemed impossible. It's so shocking to read public in fear of Islam, because in my part of the world, Islamophobia doesn't even exist. I went to an Islamic school, but I had classmates who were followers of Hinduism and Christianity. My school did not force them to accept Islam, but they did teach them to live in harmony with themselves and others. As a Fijian, I can't understand why people are afraid of Islam.
My name is Arjen, and I am an ex-Muslim. I'm an Albanian from Kosovo, land of Muslims and Christians of different sects, all bound under one nation, an example of religious tolerance in Europe. A country without terrorism ever since Islam came to our lands 500 years ago, then why would we be responsible for terrorism committed by others when during Christmas Eve, Muslims celebrate with their Christian friends, and during Eid, Christians share the joy with the Muslims? Even now, I still carry this religious awareness. The politics of blaming and stereotyping of nations on religious grounds alienates us even more from each other.
My name is Alif, Muhammad Alif Ashraf. Islam, I grew up in it. Now, I believe in it. I have been looking up to my prophet, Muhammad, peace be upon him, since I was a child. His demeanor, his posture, and his incessant smile. And I know the one that they do is not him, because they don't know how he looks like, nor do we. I am saddened because the beautiful name of Muhammad is being attributed to all the obscenity. I have Muhammad in my name too, and it affects me when I'm traveling. How? Being blamed for having that name.
My name is Islam.
From the root word of peace, salam.
I don't teach destruction nor colonization.
Those who did simply misinterpret.
Thank you.
Student Aziz and Jyoti have brought us a traditional Indian dance devoted to the Lord Ganesha, the elephant god, who is also known to remove obstacles, is the patron of arts and sciences, and is the god of intellect and wisdom. That's a lot of things for one god to do. Today is a special day, not only because we have this amazing one-word performance, but also because today is two Pearson students' birthday. The first one is already mentioned, our fellow MC Natasha's birthday. And the second one is our song crew member, my roommate, Isaac Aguzet's birthday. Happy birthday, Isaac. I'm not sure if you can hear me because I think he's backstage preparing for the very next act, the Maori Haka. It is specially written by our New Zealand student, Calvin, to present the mission of United World College Movement from a Maori perspective. It includes Hukana, which involves the protrusion of the tongue and the bulging of the eyes. It is important to the Maori culture because it symbolizes the strength of the individual spirit and intimidates the enemies. Please join me in welcoming the Haka.
Oh, I'm Marco! time together is coming to an end soon.
But before that, we'd like to thank you all for being here with us this afternoon.
We would also like to thank everyone who made this show to come together. Our act leaders, dance directors, and act members.
Those behind the stage, our lights, sound, and backstage crew.
As well as our makeup and costume team, who made us all look our best for this afternoon.
And finally, we would like to extend a huge thank you to all the host families out there who gave us a place to stay and home-cooked meals that kept us from getting too homesick.
As second years, Joyce and I unfortunately won't be here next year.
But we hope all of you will be.
Before you leave, we would like to finish the show with a Finnish song.
The song is called Finlandia. It was composed by Jean Sibelius for the press celebrations of 1899 as a covert protest against increased censorship.
The Wailers will transition seamlessly into the Finnish song after a beautiful rendition of Plivakacha, an archaic Ukrainian song that has been reappropriated and has become a song of commemoration for the Heavenly Hundred, those who were shot and killed on Maidan Square in the revolution.
再见.
До побачення.
Hyvää päivän jatkoa.
Kwaheri.
Goodbye.
Bye.